Facebook. Good evening. Welcome to another yoga class with Sally. This evening's class is a yoga flow class. So it's a class for improvers. If you're a beginner and you want to give it a go, then just do what you can. Okay, the focus of today's class is joint mobility and stability. So we're going to be looking at getting our joints moving, but also strengthening the muscles that support our joints so that we can maintain healthy joints, because it's very important to have strong supporting muscles. So before we get started, I'm just going to natter on a little bit as usual. I'm trying something a little bit new with the music front for flow class this evening. So the first flow class that I did, I put the normal music that I would put on during a flow, in-person flow class. Hey Sharon, it's lovely to see you. but Facebook warned me about copyright infringement. So last week I didn't have any music on, and I just suggested that you could put some music of your own on in the background. Today I want to share with you something that I brought into my own practice yesterday, which I really, really enjoyed. It really helped to bring me into the present moment, really helped to bring me into my flow, as it were. And that is on YouTube. I've just found some Tibetan singing bowls. And so you should, hopefully you can hear that now in the background. I find the sound really beautiful. I hope that you guys all do, and for me it really helps to connect me with the present moment, to bring me into connection with my body, with my breath, and I find it like a really calming, beautiful sound. So hopefully it's going to work well today. I also just wanted to say something about how maybe we're all feeling at this stage of lockdown, of confinement. I'm sure that the initial kind of novelty, as it were, of the situation is kind to wear off. Does it sound good, Shaz? Cool. Yeah, the novelty of the situation is kind to wear off a little bit, and probably I would expect us all to be experiencing some negativity, some negative feelings, if not all the time, at times at the moment. I know that I did yesterday. I had a bit of a wobble yesterday, and I was feeling a little bit low. So yoga can really help us with this, and I think it's important as well to not push those feelings away. So in a moment we're just going to sit and notice our breath and notice how we're feeling, and you should take that time to do that, to really get in touch with how you're feeling, to notice maybe any negative feelings that you're having at the moment, to not push them away, to notice them, to sit with them, and that can really help in processing those feelings. And also, although we're on Facebook at the moment, obviously Facebook can have quite an influence, I think, on maybe pressurizing you to feel like you're having the best lockdown ever, that Facebook is presenting you with lots of people, you know, who appear to be having lots of fun and enjoying themselves and taking everything really positively. They're not feeling like that all the time. I'm sure everybody is having their downtime. Remember to be okay with that. So now I've blathered on for long enough, let's head over to the mat. So if you don't have a mat, then you can improvise. Maybe use a rug or a carpeted area or even a towel or something like that. If you have a Mac, great. So we're just going to come, first of all, and we're going to come to a seated position on the floor or on a cushion. If you want to sit on a cushion, then please do so if you feel uncomfortable sitting on the floor. And if you don't feel comfortable sitting cross-legged, then you can also sit with your legs out in front of you, however you feel most comfortable. The important thing is that we try to sit with a straight back rather than slouching. This means that our abdomen is unrestricted so that we can breathe more easily. But also it just means that our tension is less likely to wander. If we're slouched, we're much less likely to be in the present moment than if we maintain a straight back. So to begin the session, we're just going to sit and observe our breath. So at this time, don't try to change your breathing pattern. Just breathe normally, breathe naturally, and just notice the sensation of breathing. As I say, take this time to notice how you're feeling, your emotions, your state of mind. And be honest with yourself about how you're feeling. Don't try to push any negative emotion away. But don't feel cross with yourself for feeling a negative emotion either. Don't have emotions about your emotions. Just notice how you're feeling in a non-judgmental way. As well as bringing your attention to your breath at this time, you can bring your attention to the beautiful sounds of the Tibetan singing bowls. Shanti, shanti, shanti. going to practice pranayama, breathing practice. So breathing slowly and deeply, as slowly and deeply as you can, in and out through your nose, really allowing your abdomen, your tummy to push out as you inhale, to push right out as far as you can, letting your chest expand to the maximum, to really create space in your chest, to take a full lung full of air, trying to exhale as completely as you can, engaging your tummy muscles as you exhale to draw your abdomen in, your tummy in, your belly button right towards your spine, let your chest contract. Focus your mind on your breath, relax your mind. If thoughts enter your mind during pranayama, that's okay. Don't try to push them away. Just notice them. Let them go. Return your attention to your breathing practice. Thank you. pattern. Inhale slowly and deeply through your nose. Fill your lungs as much as you can. Push your abdomen right out. And then retain your breath. Hold your breath. Count slowly to 10 in your mind. And then exhale slowly and completely. Inhale deeply. And again, hold your breath for 10 seconds. Okay, so we're going to begin with a basic warm-up, an all-over stretch from our head to our toes. Then we're going to practice Ashtanga Sun Salutations, which I will talk you through. And then we will practice a flow sequence focused on joint mobility and stability. This is a flow session, so I haven't put in rest poses between asanas, but if you want to take a break at any stage, take a break, go into a rest pose, and join back in when you feel ready. Listen to your body, listen to your mind. Throughout this flow session, we want to move with our breath. This helps to connect our mind with our body and bring us into the present moment. And throughout the flow sequence, we should maintain an awareness of the present moment, of our body, of our mind, of the environment around us. So first of all, we're going to inhale and exhale, look down to the floor. Inhale, look up to the ceiling. Keep on moving with your breath at your pace. Inhaling down. Sorry, exhaling down. Inhaling up. Slow movement, slow breath. Okay, now we're going to move our head from side to side. So we're going to inhale, exhale, turn to look over our right shoulder. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, turn to look over our left shoulder. Again, keep on moving at your pace with your breath. Inhale, front. Exhale, turn. Okay, coming back to center, now we're going to do some neck rolls a couple of times in each direction. So starting up, looking down towards your feet, roll your right ear around your right shoulder, up to look at the ceiling, left ear to left shoulder and back down to the floor. Back in the other direction, all the way around. And once more in each direction, slow and controlled. Now we're going to rotate our arms slowly, reaching out as much as we can in each direction. Again, trying to move with our breath. Inhaling, bringing our arms up. Exhaling, bringing them down. And back the other way, coming forward. Good. And give your arms a bit of a swing. Loosen up. Okay, now placing your right arm straight up so it's touching your ear. We're going to swim backwards. Okay, now coming to stand with your feet a couple of feet apart, toes pointing out slightly, hands on your hips, hip rotations, making big circles with your hips. You're going to see someone making a... Okay, and back the other way. Bringing your feet back together, hands on your knees. We're going to do knee rotations. I'm just going to turn to the side so you can see what I'm doing. So we're going to try to come up onto our toes as our knees come forward in line with our toes, and then as we straighten our legs, we come back onto our full foot. Okay, and back in the other direction. Okay, and coming back to standing position, we're just going to come up onto our tiptoes as high as we can, engaging all of your core muscles to keep you steady. Draw yourself up as tall as you can, and exhale back down. Lift up your toes away from the mat, leaving the rest of your foot on the mat. Inhale, come up onto your toes.